Hey, hello everyone. Welcome to 4Pi Academy classes, and this is Ankita Rajput. And today we came with a very interesting topic of superconductivity, that is Meissner effect. So it's very interesting and little confusing topic also. So we will try to cover this topic in a very unique way so that you can understand it very clearly. So let's start. So if you want to understand this effect, the effect, Meissner effect, so first you need to understand the little basic of superconductivity. Okay, so you have to understand what is the superconductivity, what is the phenomena of superconductivity, and also you have to understand what is the critical temperature. And third important point, critical magnetic field. So first we will understand what is superconductivity, what is critical temperature and critical magnetic field, so that we can clearly understand this Meissner effect. So we'll start with superconductivity. So this very interesting phenomena is discovered by this phenomena of superconductivity was discovered by the great physicist Kamerlingh-Ons, and he was awarded by Nobel Prize for this invention in 1913, and he was doing some experiment on mercury. Okay, and during this experiment what he did, he reduced the temperature of this mercury. Okay, and he observed that the temperature of mercury, when it reaches nearly 4.1 Kelvin, its electric resistance drop down to nearly zero. Like you can see here in this graph, this is a graph between the electric resistance and temperature, okay, for mercury. So you can see here up to this point, nearly 4.2 or 4.3 Kelvin, the electric resistance of our substance is greater than 0.10, right? And at this temperature, 4.1 Kelvin, suddenly its resistance drops down to zero, very very small. You can see here it's 10 to the power minus 5 ohm, that is nearly zero. So this phenomena, when the electric resistance of a substance drop down to zero, is known as superconductivity. Okay, so from some other experiment he observed this phenomena of superconductivity. And what, why we are calling this superconductivity? Because we know if electric resistance of a substance is very high, so we will say that it's a bad conductor, right? And when this resistance is very very small, so it will be like a very good conductor. So it is superconductivity. Okay, and there are, so this property is very specific property. We cannot observe this superconductivity in all substances. So we have few substances, few materials in which we observe this superconductivity. And the temperature, this temperature at which this phenomena is occurring, means this temperature, like in case of mercury, it's 4.1 Kelvin. So this temperature is different from different material. So we will also discuss now this temperature, that is critical temperature. So as in case of mercury, we have seen that it is 4.1 Kelvin. Okay, so it is critical temperature. This deciding temperature is known as critical temperature or transition temperature, TC. And at this temperature, a transition is taking place, means the phase of your material is changing. Okay, means at temperature greater than 4.1 Kelvin, our material is not superconductor. So it's a normal material, but below this temperature, below 4.1 Kelvin, your material is superconducting. So a phase transition is taking place at this temperature. At what? At critical temperature. Okay, and this temperature is a deciding temperature. This temperature is a characteristic temperature, and it is different for different material. So these are few examples just for references of superconducting material. Like we have some alloys, some metals, which shows the behavior of superconductivity. So like you can see, these are the common material, like aluminum, mercury, molybdenum, Pb. Okay, and these are the critical temperature. Like in case of aluminum, this critical temperature is 1.20 and so on. Okay, and these are material which are basically alloys. Okay, like you can see here Nb3SN and YbCO. So these are some list of the superconducting material. So one thing you can observe from this table that normally the critical temperature of the substances is very, very small. Okay, it's very, very small. So the scientists are trying to create, to make the substances having more critical temperature so that they can use these superconducting materials in different fields. So now we will also discuss critical magnetic field. What is this critical magnetic field and what is the role of this critical magnetic field in superconductivity? So if you apply a sufficient amount of magnetic field greater than this fixed value, critical value, so even at absolute zero, your superconducting material will convert into a normal material. So what is the meaning of this line? So let us say that this is our superconducting material. Okay, you can take any shape. This is a cylindrical shape, but your material is here, superconducting material. So it's a superconducting material. So the temperature will be less than the critical temperature TC. Okay, that's why we are saying that it's a superconducting material. So now what we did, we applied some external magnetic field. We applied this external magnetic field HC on this substance, on this material. So now you can see here, your material is not superconducting material anymore. So it is now a normal material. So superconducting material is converted into a normal material when we applied an external magnetic field HC. So this HC, this external magnetic field, this critical value of external magnetic field at which your superconducting material is converted into a normal material is known as critical magnetic field. So magnetic field which is required to destroy the phenomena of superconductivity is known as critical magnetic field. So this is a graph you can see here between magnetic field and T, temperature. So you can see here, this is a value of critical magnetic field for particular substance, we can say. So this HC is required only when your temperature is less than TC, because at temperature less than critical temperature, your material will be superconductor, right? But what will be the case when we are above TC? Like you can see here, when we are above TC, so your material is automatically normal material. So we need not to apply any magnetic field to convert our material because it's already in normal state. Okay, so this is a mathematical expression between a magnetic field and T, and it is HC equals to HC0 1 minus T over TC to the power 1 by 2. So you can clearly observe from this equation that when T is equals to TC, your HC will be zero, right? So this is the critical magnetic field. So now you clearly understood what is superconductivity, what is critical temperature, and what is critical magnetic field. So now we will discuss our topic, that is the topic, today's topic, Meissner effect. So this Meissner effect, also known as Meissner and ocean field effect, and this effect is given in 1933. And yeah, so suppose this is your material, this is your superconducting material, and you applied some external magnetic field. So this is a magnetic field lines and you are applying magnetic field. So the conditions are, your temperature is greater than TC. So if your material is kept at T greater than TC, so your material is a normal material, right? So now what we did, we reduced the temperature of our material. So now the temperature of your substance is below TC. Now it will be a superconducting material. So now you can see in this figure that these magnetic field lines, which are actually passing through your material initially, now these magnetic lines are expelled out from your substance. Okay, so that means your material is not allowing to the magnetic lines that they can pass through the material. So it expels out all the magnetic lines from its interior, from inside of this material. So what is the property? So when a material is converted from a normal material to superconducting material, it expels out all the magnetic free field from its interior. And this effect is known as Meissner effect. Okay. So what is the result of this effect? That means the superconductors exhibit perfect diamagnetism, because you all know what is diamagnetic materials. Diamagnetic material opposes the magnetic field, externally applied magnetic field. Okay, so these superconducting materials are behaving as perfect diamagnetic material. So this is the explanation of Meissner effect. So now we will see the demonstration of this very interesting Meissner effect. This experiment is very, very interesting, and it's very easy to perform in your laboratory. So this is your superconducting material. This disc type of substance is superconducting material, and this one is your magnet, and the fumes you can see here is liquid nitrogen. Okay, so we are using liquid nitrogen because you know that liquid nitrogen, the temperature of liquid nitrogen is very very, very small, nearly minus 70. Okay, so you can see here, at this particular temperature your material is superconducting, because you all know that critical temperature of different superconductors are very low. So that's why we are using the liquid nitrogen. So what you learn from Meissner effect, that in this effect your superconducting material is behaving as a diamagnetic material. So when you have this magnet and you are trying to go closer to this superconducting material with this magnet, so at particular distance the opposite forces applied by this superconducting material is that much strong that we can't move further with this magnet. Okay, and that's why at this particular position your magnet is stick. Okay, we can't move further, more closer to this material, superconducting material. So this is your Meissner effect. Okay, and you can see here, this superconducting material is repelling your magnetic material, your magnet. Okay, so that's why it is rotating, because at the edge which is facing towards this material, there will be a force, continuous force will be there. So that's why this magnet is continuously rotating. So this is a very interesting and unique demonstration of Meissner effect. Okay, so one thing you have to understand, okay, the condition which is necessary if you are performing and if you are learning about the Meissner effect, is that the strength of magnetic field, the magnetic field you are applying, the strength of this magnetic field does not exceed the value of the critical magnetic field at sea, because we have learned in last slides about the critical magnetic field. So what is this critical magnetic field at sea? This is a field which is required to destroy the phenomena of superconductivity.